Welcome back to Pathologic Classic HD. We've just attempted to save Ava in the marsh. Unfortunately, we weren't successful, but it seems like that wasn't our fault, but rather just how things are supposed to go for this day. I get the impression that there is absolutely no way to save Ava, because by the time you get here, she's already supposedly dead. So I need to deliver the documents that I got from the Watchers to the Inquisitor, and I also very badly need to sleep, because I need to regain my health, take some antibiotics to take down my infection, and then probably regain some more health. So I'm gonna head pretty much north-northwest to head up to Ava's place, go sleep there and recover, and then head over to the Inquisitor. So yeah, let's go northwest over to this little worm encampment here, and then to Ava's place. Just want to make sure I didn't miss any bodies. Nah, I think I've looted every single body, gotten all the Twyrine extracts. Huh. I just realized. You can hear frogs. I mean, of course, not that that's out of place for a marsh, but it's nice to know that some creatures can actually still survive in this place. Because it feels so dead most of the time. The simple sounds of frogs is actually really comforting. Oh, gone past the camp. Oh well. I think there's supposed to be a way over here. According to the map, there's a break in the fence right here. But I don't see a break. Oh, there's the break. I think I'm gonna chug like 3 or 4 Meridorms. Also, let's see if these guys have any bandages. Yes! Bandage. Score. Apparently I can't intimidate the rat by pointing a rifle at it. It's too strong. Why are you here? My name is Ion. I am a dancer, the daughter of Hook the Herdsman from the Boisa Kin. I'm even related to the Oyuns Mengu Kin, through my father's sister. Andre sent me here to look after the house and serve you. How nice of him. I've always wanted a servant covered in seaweed. Not really. I don't need anything. Also, please stop calling me Master. It's pretty creepy. Alright, let's make a permasave here, and let's take lots and lots of drugs. So, what's my problem? My immunity is very good right now. Hunger's low. That's all good. The problem is my exhaustion's high, my infection's high, and my health is low. If I take antibiotics, it's going to kill me, literally. So I need to heal before I take antibiotics, so I need to chug a bunch of Meridorm, probably like 2 or 3, sleep for an hour, then take antibiotics, and then sleep for some more. So let's do it. Well, I could heal, and then take antibiotics. That might be worth it. Let's see. Okay, that got my infection down pretty well. Okay, that's good enough. And then I could probably just take two Maridorm. Will two Maridorm be enough? Yeah, that's enough for now, right? Well, what time is it? 1800. 6 p.m. I don't actually have that much time left, to be honest. I want to sleep more to get the most out of my Maridorm, but truth is, I've got to get going. Because I don't know how much work is left for me to do in the main quest. So, let's go speak with the Inquisitor. Maybe I shouldn't have slept for 2 hours. Maybe I should have only slept for one. You know what? Somebody said they saw faces in the clouds of the disease that come shooting at your face. And you know what? Yeah, there are faces in the clouds. Look next time you see one of those clouds shooting at me. Look for the faces.
You found out everything I needed you to. That will do. Cheer up. These things happen.
Here's what I managed to take from the Watchers. Right, let me see. Yes, that's about what I was expecting. Numbers, dates, notes. Very good. If only those seeds of truth weren't intermixed with so much chaff. This could give us a dramatic push in the right direction. Excuse me? It seems a simple comparison won't be enough to figure out the false report. They all describe different things, and there might be two false ones. A pity. Daniil, we must hurry, before they are gone. Find out which one of them is which. Outsmart them. Outsmart them? How? One of them is a liar and a traitor. I suspect it was them that sent you those letters that would enrage you so, and even endanger your life. One of those reports is a farewell gift from them. A false lead that will put you on a false trail. How did you find that out? A friend gave me something, before I left for this place. He knew some of the internal workings of this whole affair. And questioning Vlad Olgimsky confirmed my hypothesis. Both he and Sabarov knew that there were Watchers active around here. And what about the Canes? Did they know? No. The Canes don't even know that the sun rises in the east. It is beneath them. Fine. How can I help you? Try to find out which one of them is the liar. Like in that old riddle, the traitor is sure to lie. Someone who hesitates could both lie and tell the truth. The last one will be truthful until the end. But even the truthful Watcher won't be very forthcoming. Are you up to the task? I don't know. I feel like I have to say yes, though. I think I have to be up to the task. Yes, I think I know how to do it. One more thing. My intuition tells me that you have no room for error. These people are extremely desperate now. If you accuse the truthful Watcher or the one who is still hesitating, they might react unpredictably. I know their kind. You will only have one shot. Okay, so there's... I'm just gonna write this down just in case this is, like, super important. There is supposedly the truthful one, there's the hesitant one, and then what was the other one? The one that tells the truth until the end? Truth until the end. I see. You want to take the opportunity to test my mental faculties, but I don't mind that. Anything more to say? Nope. Alright, what's happened with the quest? They don't seem to trust me. I'll have to resort to deception. I will have just one question to ask each of them. A question to which they may tell the truth or tell a lie. There's no room for error here, however. So I must first solve the puzzle myself. If only I could pass for one of them, it would be easy to unveil the traitor. They know very well which one of them is. Is that a hint? If only I could pass for one of them, it would be easy to unveil the traitor. Is that a hint about the side quest? Well, actually, it's not even listed in my quests, but is that a hint about the note that I got from Barak saying, "Find me one of the masks. The cloak and a mask. There should be some left at the theater, maybe." Is that a hint that I should go do that? Dress as one of them before I approach them? So I've got to solve the riddle first. Or solve the puzzle. So I need to what? What do I need to do? Figure out the exact right questions to ask them? To guarantee myself that I will find out who's the traitor? I know it's a classic sort of puzzle. But I've never actually really solved it, so I actually don't know how to solve it. But I suppose that doesn't exactly matter yet. Let's figure out what the questions even are. What are the possible questions? Wait, why am I going back here? I don't know why I'm going back here. I was thinking, I was in theater mode, because one of the watchers is behind the theater. But for this section, they are right here, the watcher. Should I try to find the cloak at the theater again? No, I don't have time for that. I need to solve this now. I've only got about 5 to 6 hours before the end of the day. I know that one of you always tells the truth, another always lies, and the third does a little bit of both. I hope you're not going to deny that. That is true, but how does that help you? Let me think about this. Let me think about this really hard, because this is really important. Alright, well, I've been sat here for an embarrassingly long time trying to think this through and all the different possible permutations, and I just don't get it. So, I looked up the kind of original classic example of this sort of a problem. The classic example is, like you're standing in front of a door and there's two guards. One always lies, the other one always tells the truth. And you have only one question to ask one of the guards. Gotta find out the perfect question to ask one of the guards to lead you to the correct answer. So that's the classic problem. So this is kind of a twist on that because it's not two people, it's three people. So that changes things up quite a bit. And instead of one question, you have three questions. One question for each guard, or executor in this case. Unfortunately, that's not very helpful to me. I guess I'm just bad at riddles maybe because I still don't get it. So, I'm gonna go with something, and we're just gonna see what happens and pray for the best, okay? Don't worry about it, everything will be fine. I just need to make sure I write down exactly the questions I ask, and to whom I ask them to. So, I am asking the executor... Let's see, how should I write this? So, let's say the executor of the stone... Stone... says, so let's ask him about the knots. Which of the three was the knots watcher? The liar and the traitor. Okay, so Stone says knots is liar. I'll go talk to him. So they're behind the town theater. And hey, while I'm going behind the town theater, I might as well go inside and see if I can find their suits. Hi? I think I was hanging out there pretty far. Oh god, that's right, you can't go this way. Right? Yeah, you can't go that way. Hi, plague rat. Yeah, look for the faces. See the faces in it? Ugh. Oh great, I've got two. Would you finally talk to me, Mark Immortel?
They say this Burek has managed to make a panacea.
Finally! How come I couldn't ask you for this before? Even though I'd received a letter from Burek asking me to go get an executor mask and a cloak. Well, regardless, it's here now. I need an executor mask and a cloak. Do you have any to spare? My god, have you finally decided to join my troop? Oh, no, but that would be too much of an honor. So, has the Inquisitor demoted you to an executor? I need the mask and the cloak to do a job. Says everyone who wants to remain unidentified. You are not entirely honest, esteemed sir. So what if I'm not? Every piece of clothing in my possession had to be distributed. Mass burials are a full-fledged business now. They've confiscated all the stage props. Who did? Sabarov. He has appointed one of the well-respected townspeople as the master of cremations. That is a death sentence, of course. I doubt anyone could survive that assignment. Well, obviously you can also try to get an outfit from an executor. They do still have them. I saw them dig a pit in a lot by the cemetery today. Many of them stayed there too. Okay. A pit by the cemetery, so go to a pit by the cemetery to try to find an executor who might be willing to give me their stuff. Or perhaps I should talk to Sabarov. What kind of lot? Just a lot by the cemetery. Go ask them. I'm sure they'll find a spare mask and cloak for you. And if they don't, address your complaints to Sabarov. Have a tip, kind sir? I'm actually going to give him a tip? Now off you go. So I've got another side quest. The demand for the executor's terrifying garb is unexpectedly high. How convenient the costume department of the local theater could have been if only they had a spare costume available. I should look for one of the common... look for one by the common grave where the caretakers were working. Or perhaps now would be a good time to ask Sabarov about them. I feel like I should talk to Sabarov first. Yeah, let's do that. The real question I have, though, is should I talk to the executor behind the theater before or after getting the mask and cloak? I feel like I should talk to them after. Well, I mean, if I come with the cloak after, they're not going to know it was me they were talking to before, right? So whatever I do before shouldn't make a difference. Right? So I guess I'll ask him. Let's make a permasave in case I horribly regret this, which I probably will. And we've got 5 hours until the end of the day. Okay. Okay, I guess I'm gonna ask about the other person. So Stone says the Knots person is a liar. Let me think about this. The only thing I can think of to do is ask them about each other. And if they both say the other is a liar, then that means one of them must be the liar, right? Isn't that correct? So if the Stone's executor says the Knots executor is a liar, and the Knots executor says the Stone's executor is a liar, then one of them must be the liar, right? But what about the wild card? The one that may or may not tell the truth? That just kind of ruins everything, doesn't it? I don't know. Let's try it. Let's ask them about each other. The one who does both is partly true, partly full of lies. Okay, so the Knots one says the Stone's executor is... I'm gonna call it half. They are half. Half lie, half true. Half. Alright, well that really didn't clear anything up. Regardless, let's go talk with Sabarov. And let's hope the mask and cloak that I'm hopefully going to get is going to be enough to make it so that I don't have to solve the riddle, because I feel like I'm not going to be able to solve it. Oh. Let's go straight north out here. Should be out of the infection in just a couple seconds. And by a couple, I mean 10. There we go. Ah, I can breathe again. Take in the herb vapors. Ooh, 2 revolver ammo. I will trade you 2 peanuts for 2 ammunitions. Thank you. What do you want to be when you grow up? When I grow up and become an adult like you, I'm going to be a puppeteer, like Mark Immortel. I'll do magic tricks, pull puppets by the strings, and tell fortune from someone else's bones. A daring dream. So you want to manipulate others. I just realized this kid is called Tot. Little Tater Tot. It's either that or the other way around. No, it doesn't necessarily work like that. You can be simply yourself and remain free. Hope Tater Tot takes my advice to heart and grows up to be not a Tater Tot, but a Tater Big? I don't know how to turn a tater tot into something that sounds big. I failed. Do I want more antibiotics? At this point, not really. I've got 2 left, I think. Yeah, I've got 2 of that left, plus I've still got 2 of the stronger stuff left. More rounds for this thing, might as well load them in. I think I've got 5 shots in this thing.
Yes.
Did you give the order to stop burying and to start cremating? Yes, as a one last thing, right before handing it all to Aglaya Lilich. And who did you appoint to manage the burials? One Peter Stamaton. You don't know him. Peter Stamaton? Isn't he in my list of the bound? You are wrong. I know him very well. I can't imagine a more moronic appointment. From your point of view, from mine it looks completely different. There's a cast iron logic behind this decision. I'm gonna push here. Revoke your decision. Choose someone else. There's no person in this town who deserves death more than Peter Stamaton. Oh my god, so he did intend it as a death sentence. Even if street murderers were responsible and ambitious enough for the job, I'd still choose him over them. I don't have to explain my choices to you. What the hell did Peter Stamaton do? I said revoke it. No, the decision is final and is not up for a debate. We'll see about that. You fuck. Peter has been given charge of all burials and cremations. An absurd command, or well-planned revenge. Well, obviously revenge, given what he just told me. Either way, this may be a good pretext for interrogating him as to why the governor hates him so much. I sense a hidden secret there. Yeah, Peter Stamaton, he's an engineer, isn't he? Or an artist? Or both? I'd also like to know why he actually took the job. Unless he was forced to do it.
Bad Twirin makes your head wooden. Good.
I've been told that you've been given some stage props. Executor outfits. Yes, I have. You know already. Is it true that you were appointed master of cremations? It is. Sabarov didn't have an opportunity to finish me off fair and square. I'm not subject to court. Due to me being of unsound mind. And now he has a chance to get rid of me gracefully and reliably. By the way, I've given the cloaks away to executors. I've only left one mask for myself. It's an omen. Sabarov didn't have an opportunity to finish me off fair and square. I'm not subject to court due to me being of unsound mind. So it sounds like Peter did something kind of horrible. But Sabarov was never able to actually charge him for it because he's mentally ill. Why did you give the cloaks away? They offer decent protection. I don't care anymore. It happens sooner or it happens later. What's the difference? Even if I put 10 cloaks on. Cloaks don't help the people that she's already set her eyes upon. I know this for a proven fact. Hey, get yourself together. You can't give up without a fight. Yes, yes, right you are. Actually, I'd wish they'd give me a 3-day delay, nothing more. Do you think it would be possible to arrange for them to leave me alone until, say, Friday? Only 3 days, why? I need to finish my greatest creation. It won't take long, it's just blueprints and calculations, see? Then I could go ahead and die without a moment's delay. Can't anyone find a way to deal with the bastard? Especially now that he's given up his powers? Maybe you could help. I'm curious what your greatest creation is, Peter. I could tell him there's nothing dangerous about his task. The disease withers in dead bodies. Which is true, but I don't know. You might have to wait a bit longer for it to wither in dead bodies. You might have to leave the corpses alone for a while. I don't know. I don't think he's safe. The Inquisitor can probably bring the former governor to his senses. I'll talk to her. Thank you, old boy. I'm not asking for myself, but for the art. Hush, I don't need your excuses. That finisher, hush. That was weird. It was a case of revenge, aggravated by treachery. If only they knew how easy it would be to keep the former governor in check. He is unlikely to go against the Inquisitor's orders. Having said that, the brothers were a force to be reckoned with. An artist who trusts the genius of a colleague to the extent where he is willing to kill for it is not a common occurrence. A dangerous duet indeed. Dangerous duet. Who's the other Stamaton? Andre Stamaton, right? Is that the person who runs the pub? Yeah. Oh my god, do I have to run all the way across town to talk to the Inquisitor? Jesus Christ, do I have enough time to do this? Should I go down and try to get the cloak and everything? I guess I should, it's marked on the map. Yeah, so I guess helping out Peter by trying to talk to the Inquisitor to get Sobrov in check, I guess that has nothing to do with getting the cloak and the mask. I need to go to the cremation pit for that. Or whatever that place is. So, in that case, let's leave and go talk to the third executor, I suppose. Along the way to the pit, see if we can get the cloak and all that stuff, and then go all the way across town to the Inquisitor. Yay! I feel like I'm running out of time. I've got about 4 hours and 17 minutes. Actually, exactly 4 hours and 17 minutes left in the day. Alright, well, let's not dilly-dally. The Executor is here. Let's go to the termitary, basically, and then skirt along the edge. Yep, sounds good. Not even gonna stop to look in the bins. I guess I failed at going against the edge to the termitary, but that's fine. There's another way we can take. Just take a left up here. Bandage, please. So, whoa, can you actually ask the people where the bird mask people are? I was saying, like, I think at one point I mentioned, it's possible I edited this out, but at one point I mentioned, can't you just ask people if they've seen the people with the bird masks? Oh, wait. Oh, I've already done this before. I've already seen this dialogue. Yeah, I've already seen this before. Yep. So no, they don't tell you where the executors are hiding. Because if they did, if they said like, oh yeah, just pop over there, I saw him there. I would have felt like an idiot that I searched all over town when I could have just asked a random passerby. Is this a dead end? Of course it is. Great. Hey, plague rat, I knew you'd come find me. Let's just pop in here. Ditch the plague rat. There we go. Alright, executor's over here on the right. I don't remember seeing street lamps on before. Okay, another permisave in case I ruin this. So who do I ask about? So the stone executor says the Knot's executor is a liar. The Knot's executor says the stone executor is half lying, half telling the truth. So who do I ask you about? If I ask them about themselves, they could be one of the three different types of people. If I ask them about themselves, they could say they're truthful, and I don't know. Fuck. Let me think about this again. I just keep thinking of so many permutations, and I don't get it. It's the fact that there's a third one that can always tell the truth or be telling a lie. The fact that there's a wild card that could be doing either. That keeps just throwing a wrench in the works, and I just can't come to a conclusion. I keep thinking, okay, maybe if I do this and this, but then, if it's the wild card who has given me an answer that is either true or false, could be either, that ruins everything. I don't know. I'm just... I'll try something. I'll see if I can make sense of it later. I'm gonna hope to God that the cloak that I'm hopefully gonna get will solve all my issues and I won't actually have to solve this riddle. But let's go with this. Earth says, who am I gonna ask him about? Let's ask him about the Knots. Earth says Knots is the Honest Watcher. Wait, so yeah, if he was honest, then what are you? Everyone makes mistakes sometimes. What does that mean? I am the honest servant, of course. What? What? Okay. You must be the one that either tells the truth. Wait a minute. You must be the one that either tells the truth or doesn't. You're the flip-floppy one, right? The half and half, right? Everyone makes mistakes sometimes. I am the honest servant, of course. Okay, so Earth says Knots is honest, but Earth also says Earth is honest. Okay, I think I've got the answer to this riddle. So, let's call the person who tells the truth or tells lies, the wishy-washy half-and-half one, let's just call them half, right? We've got truth, we've got lie, and we have half. This person is obviously the half person, because they just told me two different things. So they must be the half person, right? So if they're the half person, let's go back, I'm looking at my notes here. The executor in the Knots said that the executor in the stone is the half one. But if this person is the half one, then when Knots said that the stone executor is the half one, they must have been lying. So the Knots one is the liar, right? This one that I'm talking to right now is the half and half one. So when Knots says that stone is the half one, they must be lying. I think that's right. Knots is liar. I think so. What's the other option? What is the other option? Let's say this person's obviously not telling the truth, of course, because they just told me two different things. However, could they also be the one that always lies? Let's explore that possibility. Okay, if the Earth executor is the one that always lies, then both of the things they just said were lies. What they said is that Knots is honest. So if that's a lie, then that means Knots must be either half or a liar. They also said that they themselves are honest, which is obviously a lie. So if we go with that possibility, then Knots has to be either the wishy-washy one, the half one, or I don't know. I'm just gonna... Let's just say Knots is the liar. That's what it seems like. Let's just go with that. I'm pretty sure. Just about as sure as I can be. Well, I'm glad you tied your shoe there, guard. Glad you're keeping yourself busy defending the people of this town. Thanks. Walks away to take a lunch break. Okay, executors, please be here, please be here, please be here. I don't see any executors. Thankfully, I don't think I actually need them or their masks anymore. I think I solved the riddle. But still, they're supposed to be here, so where are they? Okay. Great. It does say the executors that worked at this pit haven't been back since yesterday. Does that mean they haven't been back here since yesterday, or they haven't been back to their places since yesterday? I guess it means they haven't been back here since yesterday. I guess. That would explain why they're not there. Well, in that case, let's go talk with the Inquisitor. That's the next thing to do. Talk with the Inquisitor and ask them about Sobrov. Or, I guess not really ask them about Sobrov, but I guess ask her to intervene with Sobrov's appointment of Peter Stamaton as the cremator. Time. I've got 3.5 hours to finish the day. Shit. No time to spare, as always. Sometimes I just really wish I could sprint. Almost there. Oh hey, plague rat. Came down the stairs just to meet me. Hope this fire bomber doesn't burn me to death. I should be far enough away that I think I'll be okay. Yeah, I'm good. Got 3 hours till the end of the day now. Alright, for the love of God, Inquisitor, please just get Sabarov into line.
I am not your enemy. We'll strike an alliance against a common foe, and justice will prevail.
I want to ask a favor of you. Sabarov, abusing the power he's been given, is endangering the life of a certain Peter Stamaton. Why? It seems he's trying to settle a personal grudge. And who is that Peter Stamaton? The creator of the specular tower on the other side of the river. Oh? Then his life more than deserves to be saved. Thank you. And how exactly is Sabarov needlessly endangering his life? He put Stamaton in charge of burials and cremations. The work is highly dangerous, since he has to deal with the dying all the time. We can fix that. We'll find a replacement. You have my gratitude. Now it's my turn to ask you a favor. Oh God, please, no, I don't have time for favors. It feels strange to admit that, but I actually can't achieve one of my most coveted goals in this town. Only you can help me. I've learned that Victor Kane's aloof daughter is madly in love with a certain proud fighter of death. That would be me? She is. That's news to me. At least, nothing in her behavior betrays that. Perhaps. But my request is very important. In fact, the fate of this town may depend on it. Please, arrange for me to meet with my beloved relative. She won't refuse you. Wait, Maria's related to you? Yes, the most beloved of my family. But my love is unrequited. She's prejudiced against me. I hurt her in the past. And then she was told terrible things about Inquisitors. A silly, childish prejudice. Now that we are both young women of similar age, a new meeting should help wash old memories away. There's so many strange things going on in this game. First, the Inquisitor is somebody who used to know me. Somebody who used to be known by a different name. And she just happens to come here, and even though she knows me, she just happens to be the Inquisitor sent here. Possibly arranged by the powers that be that wanted her here. And then it also turns out she's related to somebody in town. Too many coincidences. How can I assist you in that? I don't wish to force my way into a beloved person's home. I need an invitation to come in. Convince her that I mean her no harm. Or just take me to her and tell her, here, I've brought you a new friend. And then let me speak. Okay, but why? Can you please tell me why the town's fate possibly rests on you meeting with her? How do you know that? Very well, that won't be hard. But only if she really is happy to see you. Okay. So there's 3 side quests for this day. Jesus. Okay, so I need to go back to Peter to let him know about the fact that he's okay now. Doesn't have to worry about being the cremator. I need to speak with Maria. Ava's quest is done, thank God. So I've got 3 hours left in the day, and I still need to do the main quest, and I need to finish 2 side quests. Oh boy. One of those days. Alright, well, I think that's a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I am going to go speak with Maria about the meeting with Aglaya. And then after that, probably go tell Peter Stamaton the good news, see whether he gives me the mask and cloak, or if anything happens with that. And depending on what happens with that, I may or may not go accuse the Knots Watcher of being the liar, because he is the one that I believe is probably the liar.